you study about the cells, their number, okay? Cell, the main thing is unicellular and multicellular organism. What is mean by unicellular organism? The organism in which only one cell is present. These organisms are called as unicellular organisms. Second is multicellular. The organisms which have more than one number of cells are called as multicellular organisms. Now, one more thing. A cell. What a cell make? A cell. An aggregation of cell. Aggregation means a group of cell. A group of cell makes tissue. Okay? A group of cell makes tissue. A group of tissue makes organs. And a group of organs make an organ system. Okay, everyone? A group of organs make an organ system. And a group of organ system makes a human body. Understood, everyone? First of all, cells, and then the group of cells called as tissues. Group of tissues called as organs. Group of organs called as organ system. And then after organ system, what will come? A human body. Okay, a group of an organ system is called as a human body. Now, what we have studied about unicellular organism, multicellular organism. So, a very common example of a multicellular organism is an human being. Okay, and a unicellular organism, you have all heard about amoeba. Okay, amoeba, this organism, it is a unicellular organism because only one cell is present in this organism. Only one cell. Amoeba is itself a cell. Okay, all the activities, all the functions of that organism are done by a single cell. For example, in a human body, digestion, the function of digestion are done by the digestive system, excretion, excretory system. Different systems are present in our body for functioning of different things. Okay, but in unicellular organism, only one cell have to perform all these functions. Okay, but one more thing is there, that all the organism has passed that one cell stage. Okay, we also have passed that one cell stage. What is that one cell stage called? The egg. We have come from an egg, na? In our mother's womb, there was an egg. Okay, there used to be an egg. From that egg, we have come. So that egg is a single cell. So we have also come from a single cell. After that, division occurs and we have made. A human body have been made. Understood, everyone? Now we will study about the shapes of cell. Okay? Cells, shapes of cells are also very different. For example, a muscle cell, okay, the cell which is present in a muscle, the cell which is present in a muscle is like this. It's spindle shape. Spindle shape means wide from the middle and narrow from bottom. Okay, these are called as spindle shape. So it's spindle shape. Muscle cells are present in the muscle. Now nerve cell is like this. It is a branched structure. Okay, nerve cell. Nerve, you know, na? So nerve cell is a branched structure. Red blood cells, these are spherical in shape. Okay, it is visible. So red blood cells are spherical in structure. Platelets, these are also spherical. Okay, white blood cells are irregular in structure. Okay, these are irregular. They can change their shape. Okay, now the cells. Have you ever think that cell can stay like this only? No. It needs a covering so that it can be protected. Because in a human body, many cells are there. So, if cells do not have covering, then the contents will get mixed, na? So, covering is needed. This covering is called as the cell membrane. Okay? This covering is called as cell membrane. After cell membrane, what will come? In animal cells, only cell membrane used to take place, okay? Only cell membrane. But in plant cell, cell wall is also there. One additional layer of cell is called as cell wall. Why cell wall is present? To give the rigidity to the plant. Rigidity means toughness. So that it can stand straight. Okay, like human beings. Human beings used to walk from one place to another. if we will have cell wall, then we will not be able to walk. Okay, but plants don't need to walk na. That's why cell wall is present in plants. But in bacterial cells, cell walls remain absent. Okay, now we will study about size of cells. I have already explained you that it depends upon the size of an organism. Okay, if the organism is large, then large number of cells are present. Okay, so size, so this is very important, that the smallest cell of a universe is mycoplasma. The smallest cell is mycoplasma, and the largest cell in the world is called as the ostrich egg. Okay, largest cell is ostrich egg. Okay, it is the largest cell in the world, and the human nerve cell is the longest cell. Okay, it is present in a whole body na, it is the longest cell in the world. Yes, now came the discovery of a microscope. So who have discovered a microscope? So a Dutch scientist named Anton van Leeuwenhoek. Okay, he discovered microscope for the first time. Okay, so who discovered microscope? Anton van Leeuwenhoek. So now we will study about the cell structure and its functions. So what are the different functions done by the cell? We will study about that. But before going further, we will know the parts of the cell. So what are the parts of the cell? Three main parts are there of the cell. First is cell membrane, second is cytoplasm, and third is nucleus. So nucleus, what is nucleus? Like in a human body, a center is present called as brain. Okay, brain is present for controlling of whole human body. Just like that, nucleus is present in a cell for the controlling. Okay, it controls the power of the cell. It controls the cell, like what function the cell has to do. Okay, who controls? Nucleus. Cytoplasm, it is a fluid, it is a gel like substance present inside the cell. Like this is a cell. Okay, in this nucleus is present in between, it is center of the cell. Okay, and cytoplasm is jelly like structure which is spread in the whole cell like this. Okay, and this covering is called as the cell membrane. Okay, this outer covering is called as the cell membrane, and this liquid part is called as the cytoplasm, and this center of the cell is called as the nucleus. It is also called as the brain of the cell. Okay, it is also called as the brain of cell. Okay,